All right, what's going on, y'all? Today we're going to talk about how to train for an ultramarathon. Specifically, how to train for an ultramarathon if you're a beginner, if this is your first ultramarathon. A lot of you have seen my how long should you train for an ultramarathon video. If you haven't seen that, I'll go ahead and link that above. But a lot of you have been asking how you should actually go about training for your ultramarathon. So that's what we're going to talk about today. But first, I've got an easy 10-miler to go out and hit. It wouldn't be a big deal, but right now it's 28 degrees. I know all of you up north, you're probably laughing at all of us down here in Texas complaining, but this is some cold weather. You know, you can come down here and train with me during the summer when it's 102 degrees with 100% humidity. I can deal with that all day long, pretty much wearing nothing. But this cold weather, this is something else. So I'm gonna go ahead, get out there, get on the trails. I'll go ahead and vlog some of that for y'all, and then we'll go ahead and get into this training talk.
Just a little update. I'm a few miles into it, and this is cold. I do not have the right running gear for this weather. I'm wearing really light shorts right now, but still a great day to be out here.
Cold 10 miles. After the first few miles, started warming up a bit, but overall, that was pretty chilly. But overall, it was a good run. So before I get back to the house and I start going over the specifics of how you need to actually train for your first ultramarathon, or if you're still a beginner in ultras, the best way to actually specifically train for that, we gotta cover a couple things with mindset. Because in my opinion, mindset with ultramarathons is almost important, or even as important as the actual specifics, the tangibles of training. So the very first thing is, this is common advice for any race you do, whether it be a 5K all the way to marathon, but it's especially true if you're doing a 50K, 50 mile, or 100 mile, or any ultramarathon. You need to go ahead and sign up for the race beforehand. You need to go ahead and do that at the very beginning of the start of your training. You need to be locked in on having it on the calendar to keep you accountable for your training, because you frankly don't want to be missing a lot of training days and all of that. And if you don't have it concrete on the calendar, it'll be easy to go ahead and do that. I always go ahead and sign up for the ultramarathon that I've got planned at the very, very beginning of the training block. So that's number one. Number two is, you've got to know your why. When you're out there, one, in the race itself, but two, on those long, long, long training sessions, you need to have a very solid why on why you're doing this. If you don't, that's where you're going to go ahead and cut the, you know, the long run or the training session short. And then when you're out on race day, those are the people that actually quit. They don't know their why. Whereas if you've got a very solid why, barring, you know, a bad injury, you're going to go ahead and make it happen. So for me, my why is, you know, I like pushing myself into deeper and deeper pain caves. I like finding, you know, kind of my limit, and I haven't found that yet. And then with those pain caves, you know, I find, you know, what I say, peace and pain. I find the greatest amount of peace in that. So you just need to know what your why is. Everybody has a different why for why they want to do ultras. You know, for some people it's a mental callousing. And for me, in the very beginning, that's what it was, and then it evolved into what it is now. But you've got to have a very solid why that you have, preferably even written down, that you can look back on when you do start going through those really, really deep pain caves, and on those days where you don't want to get out on the trails and actually run. And then number three, it is not needed, but it is helpful to have some, you know, information types of motivation. It's nice to have some motivational things out there that you can pull back on, you know, those kind of low moments. You know, for a lot of people, that's stuff like David Goggins' books, David Goggins' book, Can't Hurt Me. For others, you know, that's watching people on YouTube, someone like Nick Bear, whatever it is for you, you know, it is useful to have some motivational things out there for you. It'll get to the point when you've been doing this long enough that you are your own motivation. And that's really cool when that happens. But until you've really, really solidified the discipline of getting out there on the days you don't want to get out there, it is nice to have at least a backup of motivational resources. So those are kind of the three quick motivational tips I've got for you, or the at least mindset tips I've got for you before we actually get back to the house. And I'm going to go into the specifics of how you should actually train for your first ultramarathon.
All right, so now let's go ahead and get into the actual specifics of how you should go about training for your first or one of your first ultramarathons. So everything I say here has actually worked well for me in the past with my ultramarathons, and it's worked well for many other people that I know in this space, training for their first ultramarathon, and then for many people, this is how they continue training for many ultramarathons after their first. So the first one that we need to talk about is weekly mileage. So, you know, it's gonna be no shock to people that the more weekly miles you put in, barring that you don't get injury, the more weekly miles you put in, the better you're setting yourself up for that race. With that being said, you don't need to go ahead and be running, you know, 70, 80 plus mile weeks every single week to have a successful first ultramarathon. That's a big kind of myth out there, is that, you know, a lot of beginners, they think that, you know, they're gonna have to devote hours and hours and hours out on the trail or out on the road to get to their first ultramarathon. The reality is, yes, you're probably gonna need more weekly miles than if you were training for a 10K or half marathon, and then many times even a marathon, but that's not always the case. I know many people out there that will be averaging about 30 miles a week and go and put out a pretty successful first ultramarathon, especially if that first ultramarathon is like at 50K. If it's a 50 miler or 100 miler or 100K, then you're definitely gonna need to put in more miles than 30 miles a week, at least in my opinion, unless your whole goal is literally just to finish. It has nothing to do with the time and how you actually feel out there. But the whole point about all of this is you're frankly gonna get out what you put in with weekly mileage. You know, I've seen a very, very, very solid number for a lot of beginners out there that if during your training block, you can build up to where you're averaging about 50 plus miles a week every single week, at least the last 6 to 8 weeks of your training block, you're going to be setting yourself up for success during your first ultramarathon. Now, with that actual weekly mileage, a lot of people ask, you know, how many days a week should you actually be running? There's some people out there that get by running 3 times a week, and they're ultra runners. They go and they regularly do ultramarathons. Then for other people out there, they'll run literally every day of the week. They'll run 7 days a week. For me personally, I recommend about 5 to 6 times per week. But you know, if you're really, really tight on the schedule, but you can go ahead and get 3 to 4 you know, more volume miles in, you can go ahead and do that. My whole recommendation here is you need to work this around your schedule to where you're going to be consistent with getting those miles in on those very, very specific days. So if that means you can only run, say, 4 times a week, you're going to absolutely get those 4 runs in a week and get all of the miles that you've got in planned during that time. But with this whole thing, is you've got to have a very, very, very solid plan. So with that, for most beginners, you're not going to know how to appropriately train for an ultramarathon since you don't have the experience. That's where I recommend, you know, there's a lot of free plans out there that are great. You can go ahead and purchase a plan. Myself, I've put out 50K and 50 mile plans if you're interested in that, but there's many, many, many other coaches out there that they also have plans as well. So if you vibe with some other people, they've got plans as well. The whole point here is I would recommend going ahead and finding a plan, whether that's free or paid, and really, really following that to a T. Don't miss the miles on that. Get your weekly miles in and get the actual training sessions in that's scheduled for you. So if you're doing 4, 5, 6 runs a week, you're getting all of those in on time. So along with getting your actual weekly miles in, getting the actual days of running in, another big difference from say just half marathon and marathon training is the actual long run itself. So, you know, with half marathon, marathon training, a lot of times you'll have a long run, say, set on Saturday or set on Sunday, and then the next day will be a rest day. In the ultramarathon world, most people, not everybody follows this, but most people like to have a long run and then the next day actually be a medium run. So you're actually running on tired legs. Because in an ultramarathon, say 50 miles plus, you're going to get to where your legs are very, very, very tired. So you want to essentially simulate that with your training so you're used to that and you get your body used to it as well. So that's where you might have, say, a 20 miler on Saturday and then a 12 to 14 miler on Sunday. It all depends on where you're at in the training block. But keep in mind that if you can go ahead and fit in those back-to-back long runs, that's gonna set you up for huge success in your first ultramarathon. So another question I get from a lot of beginners is how much speed work should they do for their first ultramarathon? So for a lot of the people that I coach, I actually don't have them do any speed work at all for their first ultramarathon. After that, then of course we add that. But for a lot of people, I don't even recommend doing speed work unless they've got a long time to train for that first one. But if you only have a few months, I am of the belief it's better for you to be in that aerobic threshold for the majority, if not all of your runs. You're not hurting yourself by taking away the speed work. And if you look at the speed work of most ultramarathon runners out there, it's not going out and doing, say, 400 meter repeats. It's usually mile, two mile repeats, tempo runs, a lot longer type speed work. So if you do want to add the speed workout in, rather than doing, say, the 80-20 rule, which is what a lot of marathoners do, to where 80% of the runs are aerobic and then 20% of the runs are anaerobic, I suggest doing about 90-10. So 90% of your runs being aerobic, 10% of your runs being anaerobic or that speed work. And that's, again, going to set you up for huge success with your first ultramarathon. So with that being said, you don't need speed work to get through having a very, very successful first ultramarathon. If you haven't already seen my video on how to run longer, definitely check that video out. I go through and I explain essentially how you can go ahead and just build up a very, very, very robust, healthy, aerobic system. That way you can keep powering all day long. And essentially, that's where you hear the phrase, train slow to race fast. You need to go ahead and probably slow down your runs. If you're not already following heart rate training, whether you're following, you know, say off of a wrist heart rate monitor on your watch or a chest strap, I highly suggest you start getting into heart rate training. The most simple kind of method out there, it's not the most accurate, but it's accurate enough, especially for ultra runners, is MAF, M-A-F. Definitely go ahead and look that up. Once again, you can go ahead and check out my video where I explain it. But if you go ahead and you really follow heart rate training to a T, and then you race in that heart rate zone or just a smidge higher, you will have an extremely successful first ultramarathon, and every ultramarathon after that will be very, very, very successful for you. Another tip that I have for you is try to get at least three runs in, if not more, three runs in over 20 miles. That's just gonna help you go ahead and have the confidence for you to actually go ahead and finish that distance on race day, especially if you're doing a 50K. If you've already gone ahead and you've done, say, a 20 mile long run, a 24 mile long run, and if you've done a marathon in there, you know that you can go ahead and finish that 50K and you can finish it strong. If you've got a 50 miler and you've got all these runs in, say, from 20 to 30 miles in your training, you know you're gonna go ahead and mentally be able to push that extra 20 miles out on race day. So the whole point here is try to get in as many long runs as possible, especially those really, really, really long runs. And this is where it'll come down to whatever training plan you're following, they'll have that set up in there. Most ultramarathon training plans will have you doing at least three pretty long runs. Many have quite a few more. But the whole point is the more you do, the more it's gonna set you up to have that confidence on race day that you can go ahead and finish. Because when it comes down to running your first ultramarathon, you're going to go through some pain caves. That's the beauty of ultramarathons. You get to go through those deep, deep, deep pain caves and then come out the other side, finish the race, and then have that extreme feeling of accomplishment and knowing, frankly, you can tackle just about anything. But you've got to go ahead and build that confidence up first with your training. So have those long runs built in there. The biggest tip I have for you when training for an ultramarathon versus, say, training for your first marathon or half marathon is really, frankly, the heart rate training. While I would suggest that as well for half marathons and marathoners, it is incredibly important for us ultra runners to go ahead and build a massive, massive, massive healthy aerobic system. And you're gonna do that very, very efficiently if you follow heart rate training, specifically if you follow MAF training. But that's my biggest tip out there. So go ahead and really, really focus on through training, building up yourself mindset-wise. You need to go ahead and start kind of figuring out how to mentally callous yourself that when you do hit those pain caves, you're gonna push through them. But then also go ahead and really follow a legit plan One that you trust and one that you're actually going to be able to stick to. If one, you know, has a plan that has you running 6 days a week and you don't have 6 days a week to run, whether it be work, all of that, you need to go ahead and find another plan. But find a plan that fits your schedule, fits you, and follow it to a T. Try not to miss many training runs, if any at possible, and you will set yourself up for success. Don't be so concerned with going out there and trying to run, say, 7:30, 8 minute miles on every single training run, unless you're, you know, super fast already. Don't be doing that on every single training run if your heart rate is already up in the 160s, 170s. You want to go ahead and be in that aerobic zone, and then you'll get more and more and more efficient at that heart rate itself. And then you'll be able to maintain it all day long. You'll be digging into your fat reserves rather than just burning glycogen. So it's all good stuff. But those are my tips for you today on how to train for your first ultramarathon. If you guys have any questions, definitely drop them down below. I'd love going ahead and connecting with all of you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please go ahead and drop a like. Hit subscribe if you haven't already. Be happy, be positive, be powerful. Have a great rest of your day.